the divorce rate is much higher than the marriage rate. Why? Because we are not adhering to the marriages of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We want everything to be lovey-dovey and honeymoon and everything's cool, but we don't realize, but when the bills kick in, when you have to start to pay and you have to start to look after, that's when the tough time of life comes in, people give up. Now we have a trend. We have a trend in the United Kingdom. People get married and they go on a honeymoon. They go on the same plane, but when they return, they come on different planes. Seriously, this is becoming a widespread trend. When they go on honeymoon, they go on the same plane. When they return, they come on different planes, different airports and different times. And that's it, it's finished. Why? Because it's not based upon true love and true loyalty. People think true love is, oh, you found somebody on Facebook? Oh, they look very nice. They look very handsome. You don't know about their qualities. You don't know about their family. You don't know how they grew up. You don't know what they've been up to in life. You want to marry them? Oh, I've fallen in love. No, you haven't. You've given your heart cheap. That's what's happened. You've given up the most precious thing that Allah has given you just to somebody you found on Facebook, just to somebody who tweeted you, just to somebody who sent you a WhatsApp message with an icon picture of their face, which was covered with foundation. Really, this is the reality of the time that we live in. None of this is love. All of this is fake. All of this is fake. True love only comes out at times of difficulty. You test the waters when times are troubling. You don't test the waters when everything is fine and everybody is in happiness and in comfort. When you go through a troubling time, you want to find a friend who's going to come and give you a hand. But you know what happens in troubling times? Oh, people say, oh yes, I was busy, I didn't see my phone. My WhatsApp wasn't activated, my Facebook was down. Fusihim. They will give up that which they are in need of, that which they have, they will give it up and give others priority over themselves. This is why Sayyida Khadija, her amazement is like no other woman upon this earth. Her greatness is not like any other woman. We can't even imagine to comprehend how great this woman was when the Prophet was in such difficult times that he would walk in the streets of Makkah and his Sahaba would be tortured in front of his eyes. It was Khadija who would give him comfort. It was Khadija who would give him peace and give him tranquility at home and make him feel that Allah will help. Allah will send victory and Allah will send success. The Makkan life wasn't easy. Do you know the Prophet would walk past the family of Sayyidina Ammar and they would be tortured. What would he say? Sabran ya ala Yasir, fa inna maw'idakum al-jannah. Patience, O family of Yasir, for your destination is paradise. He couldn't do anything for them. And the first martyr of Islam, the first person who gave their life up for Islam, was Sayyida Sumayya radiallahu anha. It was a woman. The Prophet would see this in Makkah. Who was it that was giving him comfort? His mother had passed away, his father had died before he was born, his grandfather had passed away. There was nobody except Sayyida Khadija radiallahu anha who was giving him love, giving him affection, pouring onto him everything, every loyalty that she had in her heart towards the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We can't even imagine the greatness of this great woman. Just listen to what the Quran says. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Ya nisa an nabiyyi. لَسْتُنَّكَ أَحَدٍ مِّنَ النِّسَاءِ O wives of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you are not like any other women. If that's the case of all of the wives, then at the top of the list is Sayyida Khadija radiallahu anha, who not only was his wife, but she was the mother of his children. Not only the mother of his children, she was the mother of Sayyida Fatima and the grandmother of Sayyiduna al-Hasan wal-Husayn radiallahu anhum ajma'een. The greatness of this great woman is beyond comprehension, is beyond understanding, is beyond human mind as to how much loyalty and how much love she gave the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And true loyalty and true love that she would give up everything of hers for her beloved husband sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would come home after a hard day of being in the busy mists of Makkah, she would place her hand on the chest of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and give him comfort. And she would comfort him. He lived with Sayyida Khadija for 24 years without marrying any other woman. And she was years and years and years older than him. And she was a widow not once but twice. And she had children before him. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam still married her and showed her so much love and showed her so much loyalty that when Sayyida Aisha radiallahu anha said, مَا غِرْتُ عَلَىٰ أَحَدٍ مِّن نِسَاءِ النَّبِيِّ sallallahu alayhi wa sallam kama ghirtu ala Khadija. She said, I was never jealous of any of the wives of the Prophet the way I was jealous of Khadija. Why? He wouldn't enter into his house or exit from his house except that he would make mention of Khadija. Khadija was the wird of his tongue. Day and night he would speak about Khadija. And Sayyida Aisha said, Messenger of Allah, she was an old woman. Allah has given you a young virgin woman. And the Prophet's face would go red. And he would say, I swear by Allah, Allah has never given me better than Khadija. This was our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Who they speak about, we don't know. And we don't want to. Sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to her, towards the end of her life, when she was upon her deathbed, the Prophet said to her, I know this is a difficult time, but sometimes through difficulties, Allah brings ease. And through this difficulty of yours, the ease that Allah will bring to you, that I will be your husband in the gardens of paradise. And Sayyida Khadija said, is that the case? Really, will you be my husband in Jannah? And the Prophet said, indeed, I will be your husband in Jannah. And Sayyida Khadija radiallahu anha, she was so happy and joyful that she said, بِالرَّفَاءِ وَالْبَنِينَ May it be with happiness and many children. And Sayyida Khadija radiallahu anha, after 24 years of marriage with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, through living through a difficult time of the Meccan life, she didn't migrate to Medina. Medina was the time when they have comfort, when ease came to the Muslims, when it wasn't the difficulties of Mecca, but it was only Khadija who lived through the difficulties of Mecca. Why? Because of the bravery of this woman, the courage of this woman, the strength of this woman, the determination of this woman, the iman and faith of this woman, the love of and loyalty of this woman was such that no other woman would have been able to bear the difficulties of Mecca except Khadijah.